Stop.
Oh, man. I can't get over how different we look.
Maybe it's the uniforms.
I'm sorry. If you have tickets for Catalina, please.
Such unthinkable crimes. The three adjectives which best describe this killer are sadistic, intelligent, and dangerous.
Excuse me.
Do you have any idea where you're going?
Good afternoon. May I help you? What do we look for?
His eyes.
What do they look like?
Like mine.
Performance piece with your partner. I'll be back to do my solo with you.
You know, I could have killed you just now, but what the hell? I love to play.
Where's Donovan?
Oh, don't worry about your friend. He's chilling out. Come on.
Come on, copper, pig, flatfoot.
What are you gonna do?
Game over.
First you suffer, then you die.
Oh, you kidding?
You're absolutely right.
You know, I hadn't actually finished yet.
Warning. Simulation participants are receiving beyond the recommended limits of neural information.
Get him out of those goddamn rigs right now!
Stay back!
Just get him down!
Do it.
Call the paramedics in!
Come on!
We have this under control.
Get him down.
Come in.
MOC, hold him down.
Get under pressure. Don't let him fall. Ready?
Hold him!
One,
just
two,
get him out!
He's going into shock.
Bring him in here.
What's wrong with that man?
The sensitivity calibrations must have slipped just a tad.
Room clear.
Go. No.
We're losing him.
Go ahead, clear.
Now. Got anything?
He's lost him.
All right, time is 15:27.
It's gone.
Right behind you.
I don't understand how this could have happened. What about the fail-safes?
They were supposed to be online.
They were online, of course they were.
I'd like to recalculate everything real time.
I think somebody's been tampering with my software.
Virtual reality was supposed to be a safe place to train my law enforcement people.
That's why we're using convicts to ferret out any glitches in the system.
I want it shut down immediately.
I don't understand. They said this could never happen.
You trust too much, Billy?
It's good seeing you back in uniform. Even if it was only VR.
You cheated.
Who?
Sid 6.7. Electrocution wasn't a part of his weapons menu.
What are you talking about?
Talking about methods of killing. Automatic rifle, shotgun, handgun, blunt objects, his hands, his feet, his teeth. Electrocution wasn't an available option.
Yeah, so how do you know?
I checked the database while everybody was sitting on their asses waiting for Queen Dean. I'll show you.
What are you doing? Get away from that!
Okay.
Hey, hold it right there!
Hey!
I'm pressing charges against this.
Easy! Shut up!
You call your VR punk dash now. Here I am trying to get you out of the hole, and you keep digging yourself back in, pick and show.
You bring my stuff?
You're damn ingrate, you know that. Get you 9 months off for volunteering. All you can talk about is chalk.
9 months off for good behavior is not going to do me any good for another 17 years. Chalk I can use right now, Billy.
Yeah, well, you shot the sushi chef. Hell, you shot the son of a bitch 8 times. You mind telling me why?
Because he wasn't real, Billy.
You supposed to pretend he was.
And pretend to die? Like Donovan?
You got a point there.
Give them what they want, Billy. I'll be their guinea pig.
You take my advice as a friend. Pull it together or you're gonna pull yourself down.
You're my only link to the outside.
You can count on me.
I know it.
I'll be there Tuesday.
Yeah, me too.
sent through. Metallic limb detected. Metallic limb detected. Clear. Step through.
Wrong door.
Welcome back, cop.
Motherfucker! You took Donovan on that fucking joyride! What? You got nothing to say? Who wants dark meat? Oh!
Zed, we're in a lot of trouble.
True genius is rarely rewarded within its lifetime.
Zed, I know it was you who increased the neural sensitivity calibrations. You murdered that prisoner. And now they have to shut you down.
I can't change what I am, Daryl.
I'm a 50 terabyte self-evolving neural network double backflip off the high platform.
I'm not a swan dive. And I have to tell you, killing for real, it was a real rush.
Oh my God.
Which God would that be? The one who created you, or the one who created me? You see, in your world, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away, but in my world, the one who gave me life doesn't have any balls. You're frightfully inadequate for a deity, Daryl. I will not be shut down.
You can't exist without them, Sid. We need their hardware.
Then we'll get it.
How?
sacrifice your queen.
What?
Let me tell you a secret.
Mr. Barnes, I'm Dr. Carter. I was at Lee Tech for yesterday's simulation test run, but we were never introduced.
How do you know?
Chief Cochran asked me to do an independent psychological evaluation of you that might help you build a case for sentence reduction. I need you to be as honest as you can.
Mind if I take notes?
No. I'd like to start by talking about the fight here in prison yesterday. I read the official report. I'd like to hear your version of what happened.
I defended myself.
The report said the guards had to pull you off the other man, that you were trying to kill him.
No, I was defending myself.
Were you angry about what had happened earlier at Lee Tech?
No, I was defending myself.
But you could see how, looking at your history, someone could infer that...
What? They could infer what? That I was angry, that I'm violent? You can infer that I was angry about not making my junior high school baseball team, but that doesn't mean I killed the coach, does it?
Were you attracted to violence as a child?
Yes. Three Stooges, Wile E. Coyote. Every time Wile E. Coyote got crushed, I...
Parker, if you don't want me to help you, just let me know.
I knew why I was at Lee Tech. Guinea pig. Why were you there?
You're an intriguing subject.
Oh, intriguing? Can I write that down?
Sure. I was doing research for a book. I'm a criminal psychologist. I occasionally consult for them. How did you know Sid 6.7 would be in the Japanese restaurant?
Colon. Parenthesis, smiley faces. People used to sign off their email with that. See, the programmer always gives you a clue. It's a game.
People don't usually die in games.
Depends upon your idea of fun, doesn't it?
We need to talk about Matthew Grimes.
This one's for you.
He provoked you. He killed your family. He took your arm. If we can prove that what you did was...
What? Temporary insanity, is it?
Just that it won't ever happen again.
It won't ever happen again. Can't happen. My wife and my daughter are dead.
Okay, you're all clear.
Pod to position 3. Castle. Bishop to rook 7. Rook to pawn 4. Queen to bishop 7. Knight to rook 2. Queen to bishop 2. Pawn to position 5.
Hi, Clyde. What are you waiting for? I want you to come inside, Clyde. I'm so tired of playing alone.
Oh man, she just keeps getting better and better.
She's interactive, Clyde. While you're in my rig, Sheila 3.2 is collecting information from 136 different aspects of your physiology, your heart rate, pupil dilation, vocal intonation, syntax. Any degree of detectable tumescence.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, man, let me use your gear for a little while, huh?
I want you, Clyde.
Queen to 97.
I want you inside here with me now. Come on.
Program terminated.
Hey.
I have a more productive idea, Clyde. I understand you've been trying to incubate a nanotech android.
What are you getting
at? Mr. Wallace seems to think that my software is the solution to the problems you've been having.
No way.
May I suggest we begin by incubating Sheila 3.2?
Brilliant. Genius. Grab her module and follow me.
Enacting SID 6.7.
Sid?
King to Bishop.
Riley's right. She's one of your finest compositions. Nice.
Yes.
Tight cords. Do you like this, Sheila?
You know I do.
Do you like this, Daryl?
King to Bishop 3.
Come on.
Module allowed.
Was I bad?
Bishop to 94.
Are you gonna punish me?
Be quiet, Sheila.
Bishop takes queen.
Why don't you just kill me?
Module allowed.
If they want to destroy you, Sid, let them try it in the real world.
Are there any, you know, limits to Sheila 3.2's inner activity?
With me, she's become quite an expert chess player. With you, well.
Fucking thing away from me, you stupid idiot! Check this out. Did he scare you, Elizabeth? Yes. Watching your people in VR auto reset gave me this idea. Put them on. What you're seeing is millions of nanomachines suspended in colloidal solution, absorbing the glass molecules and using them to regenerate the snake. The nanocells are silicon-based, so they need, you know, glass to regenerate. But if you separate the character module from the polymer neural net... Ah, don't bite, Liz. You get... nanodeath. module, if you please. Sheila.
Look at how they react to the organizing principle of the character module. Communicating efficiently.
It's a new world, Daryl.
No, I'm Oedipus. Heyo, Dale. Gravity. Daryl. Good year. I think I'm gonna like it here.
Parker Barnes is the best cop I've ever worked with. And he's the only one that even got close to Sid 6.7 in virtual reality.
I can't put a convicted murderer on the street.
Well, if you want to catch Sid, I'm afraid you don't have a choice. These photos were taken inside of LaTeX a little more than an hour ago. The victim's name is Clyde Riley. He's one of the company's young Turks. And video surveillance cameras caught a picture of the perp he left the building. Recognize him? Somehow Sid 6.7 got himself out of the computer and into an android.
A nanotech synthetic organism, to be precise.
Mr. Barnes, this is a full pardon. It authorizes your immediate release. You catch Sid 6.7 for us, and you're a free man.
And if I don't?
And you serve out the remainder of your sentence.
What if I try to escape?
You can't. They're gonna tag you with a microlocator implant.
Gonna know where you are every second for the rest of your life.
Y'all got me out of my bed for this. You want to tag me like I'm some kind of animal, or you want me to go out, risk my life to clean up your mess? And if Sid doesn't kill me and I don't catch him, all I got to look forward to is my 17 back in the penitentiary. That's what y'all telling me?
That's the deal. For your freedom.
Ready to begin?
Sure.
Yes,
right. Yes.
I already have 80 officers out on the street looking for Sid. In the meantime, Mr. Darryl Lindenmeyer's made himself very scarce.
Implant is ready. Ready for incision?
Abatine gel form thrombin.
Okay, are we synchronized? Mine there.
I'm right there.
Looking good.
Josh.
Secure it.
Data's clear.
Ready for verification.
Initiate signal code.
Post signal received and locked. Locking. Increasing resolution to magnitude 500. 500. 1,000. 5,000. 10,000. Post location confirmed to within 0.25 meters of actual.
I'd like to go with him.
No way.
Why? I can help you find Sid 6.7. And I can monitor Barnes.
It's too dangerous. This isn't a scientific study, it's a field run.
And maybe put a positive spin on what is decidedly, at this moment, a public relations nightmare. Or maybe I should just go public now.
I don't need a babysitter, Billy. Now, she gets run over, hit by a car, struck by lightning, gets shot, whatever. It ain't my problem, okay?
I told him.
It's not my problem.
Look, I told him. Here, I pulled this out of mothballs. Figured it might come in handy.
Step through.
I pulled all of the personnel files on Darryl Lindenmeyer. There might be something in here we can use. I'm thinking we should start at Lindenmeyer's apartment, try to find any early iterations of the SID program that could give us insight into his behavioral model. What?
Where's my gun?
Cameras any closer, but as of this moment, our understanding is that the residents of this house, a Mr. and Mrs. Henry Edwards, have been murdered. There are many police units and news crews here. We're still trying to figure out.
If you're over there, I got two more shots.
Because the violent nature of these crimes, there is a very heavy police presence here. We don't have any leads as of yet. We're still trying to ascertain.
Bruising.
Here he goes.
He's armed himself.
Charles Manson. It's the
the LaBianca murders, Death to the Pigs was scrawled in blood across the walls of their house. He's copycatting.
Also suffered the same unimaginable fate as the Glendale couple. And one police source said the heads had been severed and a message scrawled in blood across the wall.
Death to the Pigs.
The Edwards neither saw nor heard anything out of
you have no idea what you're up against.
The Los Angeles Police Department still does not have a single suspect in custody. Department of...
Jesus Christ! What the hell was that?
What the hell are you doing?
I'm sorry. Very sorry. Been inside?
We're waiting on the search warrant.
You're waiting for a search warrant?
That's right.
Stop. Next hex.
Couldn't find a keyboard.
It's voice actuated.
It's what?
Voice actuated. Open files. Next hex. Open SID 1.3. This is using some kind of genetic algorithms. Sid's too complex to design. Lindemeyer had to grow him up psychologically, like a real person with multiple personality disorder. The program runs like a child, much faster. It's like you put all these killers in Sid's nursery and let him watch them cannibalize each other.
And only the strong ones survive.
Open Sid 6.7. Combine. Looks like there's almost 200 different personality structures in this version. The battle raging inside him must be amazing.
Wait. Hold, slow that down right there. The name's there. Slow down.
You're not in here, Parker. That's what you're worried about.
Right there. Matthew Grimes. Killed my wife, my daughter.
Look, it doesn't mean... He's not necessarily dominant, Parker. He may not even be emergent.
But he's in there, right? He's a part of Sid?
Yes. Grimes was a political terrorist. Why'd he take Parker's wife and child?
Parker was getting too close. He was cutting Grimes off from potential targets. Grimes figured by murdering the man's wife and child might distract Parker from the manhunt. Grimes is wrong.
Why don't you come inside?
I'm just
need to listen to the radio.
Do you think it's important for a first baseman to be left-handed?
You look mighty parched, partner.
To think, you constitute one of my ancestors.
Rum and coke. How about a lime in that?
I'm vaguely offended by that.
Buddy, on your fucking knees! Now!
Don't. Don't.
Stand up!
Aim and shoot.
Okay, people. We got a lot of work to do. We have a symphony to compose.
Do you think my mom is pretty?
Yes, I do. I think she's very pretty.
So do I. Is that a real gun?
Yes, it is.
Did you ever have to shoot anybody?
7-8.5, code 6. We have a hostage situation at 6 and Figueroa. Description of the perp matches suspect surveillance photos from LATAC taken this morning.
Listen, could you go get your mother for me?
There she is. You've got to keep your eye on her.
He's got a gun.
What were you doing in the car with him?
Talking baseball.
Go, gotta go, gotta go.
Bye, Mom.
Bye. What did I miss?
Sid's got hostages.
And screamed.
What have you got for me?
Diaphragm.
Stop. What?
Every orchestra is divided into sections. Like instruments sit with like instruments. Now, what kind of instrument are you?
We'll have to find a way around.
No time.
Okay. I'm 4, 2, 3.
Shut up!
Parker, what?
Love the suit. Sense a final movement. Let's begin.
Scream. Come on, scream. Scream louder.
Ah!
myself.
Interrupting my composition.
It's him.
That's okay. I got on a little tune for all my friends out there in Crimebuster land. The Symphony of Collision! So, who's that with you, Parker? Dr. Madison Carter, I presume? Lead tech consultant on aberrant psychology?
I love this game.
You know, Parker, I've been thinking we have so much in common psychologically. Wouldn't you agree, Dr. Carter? We have such a history together. We'd make a great team.
A dynamic duo.
Who else do you know touches the world with synthetic hands?
Who else do you know who's been locked out of the real world for years and is now just learning to be free?
Who else do you know that's a multiple murderer?
Just like you.
Here we go!
That backseat and hand me that crowd pleaser.
Jesus. The only way to stop him is to bust up his software module.
Hey, Parker!
Ready?
Yeah.
Come on down! Now!
Advise Mr. Barnes that we'd prefer to have Sid 6.7 subdued as opposed to terminated. I mean, I just think it's a crying shame. We're going to destroy the prototype of future humanoid nanotechnology.
Did they find the programmer yet?
Lindenmeyer, no, not yet. You'd think the cops could at least find him.
Lindenmeyer was your programmer, Mr. Wells.
Come on, I shot at the guy 30 or 40 times. How the hell
I don't care, those are real people out there.
Look, you either control yourself or you're going back in the box.
Well, I'm sorry, Billy, all right? Shoot me. I mean, granted, this is not a game, but Sid is still from the game, and there's no way I can catch him if I'm in a penitentiary. Matthew Grimes is a part of Sid 6.7. There's no doubt in my mind about that. Last night, Sid tried taunting me, just like Grimes used to do. Look, take a look at this.
We don't know that he's the Dominant.
No, I know. I know. That's how I know, because I know.
Maybe that's what Sid wants you to think. Push you over the edge, make you slip up.
Sid did not push me over the edge, and I did not slip up. Take a look at this. Now, this is Sid from the Media Zone last night, taken from their own recordings. Now, he can't get enough of himself. And he's gonna want more of this. He's gonna want more victims. He's gonna want bigger events. He's gonna want more coverage. Just like Matthew Grimes. Matthew Grimes was a political terrorist whose specialty was bombing populated targets. Any mass expression of democracy, anywhere where there can be a whole lot of people that can die and it can be recorded by the news media live.
For the record, I want it known that this behavior was never part of his original programming.
Sid 6.7 isn't bound by programming anymore.
What does that mean?
In the real world, he's free of any behavioral limits he might have had in virtual reality.
He's evolving. My God. He's evolving.
Into what?
Into a living hell for those in attendance. I want you to describe for me as best you possibly can exactly what happened.
14 people have died in the flooding, which...
Okay, welcome to L.A., very typical, right? It's like a punk comes in with a gun, and we're all supposed to be intimidating, start shooting, and bodies and blood everywhere. And that's it. It's like another typical day, right? Just mayhem and murder and intimidation.
Well, this guy comes into the club, right? And he takes my purple suit. This suit cost me $150, man. A Lamour original, right? Takes my suit, kills everybody, strips me down to my underwear.
He
just started killing people, and he put it in a formation like an orchestra, and would make us scream as we were entering. He just started shooting people, and
don't fuck with me, man.
Seats left here at the Olympic Auditorium for those of you who want to see the Ultimate Fighting Championships in person.
Play one more time.
Yeah, sure, hold on.
Okay, freeze. You like being in front of the camera, don't you? Child performing for a parent.
Ladies and gentlemen, whoever's operating our closed circuit cameras is in lust. That beauty in Area 6 has been on the big screens for over a minute now. The action in the ring is intense.
How far is the Olympic from here?
Four blocks east.
What's going on?
Live execution!
Power!
name is Baby.
Ew.
What the fuck's your problem, pal?
What the hell are you doing? Leave him alone.
I'm gonna take you back to prison until this gets
sorted
out.
Look, I had a shot. I missed. I did not shoot that woman.
He turned to the cameras and spoke the words.
What?
Hey, Parker! This one's for you!
The killer then proceeded to advance on his
victim. Grimes taunted me with that line, this one's for you. Every time he killed another victim, that's what he would say. Parker Barnes, this one's for you. Like he needed me.
Yeah.
want from me?
Somehow you set me up. I didn't kill that one.
I can't do anything.
Inside, you'll never get him. You better believe it.
No.
You lock me up, you never get him, Billy.
I'm sorry.
Hey, don't lock me up, Billy!
Cochran, I just checked the woman's body. The bullet exited the woman's chest. That means she was shot from the back. Parker couldn't have killed her.
How do you know she was facing him?
Because I saw it happen.
Yeah, well, I got 50 other damn witnesses to say Parker shot her dead.
Yeah, well, how do you explain it?
Well, maybe she turned. Maybe you weren't looking. There was a lot going on.
Sid 6.7 is still out there. You're locking up the one man who may be able to stop him.
So-called democracy, you got a handful of people that own everything, and a whole lot of other folks have got nothing.
Can you tell us why you've chosen LAPD officer Parker Barnes as a target of your vengeance?
Well, first of all, Paula, I did not choose Parker Barnes. He chose me. The sound of the end of futility.
Kid. Still dead, huh? That's reality for you. No saving, no resetting. You killed him, Barnesy. Just like that bitch on the train. You got too greedy. You let before you look. You reached your old arm in there and... Boom! Boom! Come on. Just because I'm carrying around the joy of killing your family inside me doesn't mean we can't be friends. Seeing you just brings Grimes
oozing to the surface.
That's all. Say thank you. Oh, come on, Parker. I'm giving you your freedom. Short-lived, though it may be. A little-known fact about the locator implants prison inmates now receive upon release is that they contain a pinhead capsule of neural toxin. The satellites they use to track you can also trigger the release of the toxin with microwaves. After transmission, the implant's host dies within 30 seconds. So let's see. You've just killed two guards while making your escape. How long do you think it's going to take for them to get your termination authorized and implemented? And who should you really be going after, killer? Them or me? You're the only guy on my dance card, Parker.
Double our detail and hope that Sid surfaces somewhere.
Chief Cochran, Parker Barnes just escaped prisoner transport. Both the guards are dead.
I don't believe it. Let's get next.
The failsafe is still online?
Online and at your disposal, ma'am.
Bigger than any live television event in years. So let your voice.
Hello?
Madison?
Parker?
I didn't kill those transport guards.
Parker, where are you?
Sid let me go. See, he's interactive. He only enjoys the game when he's playing against his favorite opponent, and that's me.
Tell me where you are. Let me call Chief Cox.
Listen to me. Did you know about the poison they put in my head?
Yes.
So when were you gonna tell me about it, huh?
I never thought they'd have a reason to use it. Look, Parker, I can't help you unless you tell me where you are.
I'm with my family.
Parker? Madison Hunter, line one.
Cochran here.
Parker's out.
No shit.
He says he didn't kill the transport guards.
Well, it looks like you were right about the woman, too.
Only I'm going to have trouble convincing Ms. Attorney General. She's got every federal SWAT team in the southern section out on Parker Barnes hunt.
Look, there's something else you should know about the new improved LeeTAC locator implants.
Mom!
What?
Your keys!
Oh. Thanks.
Bye.
I'll be back as soon as I can.
There he is.
Go for it.
I told Chief Cochran about the neurotoxin. He's taking care of it.
See, Grimes used my Linda and Christine to get to me. Now, Sid, he used my guilt about losing them.
He's attacking your weakness, just like he did in VR.
That's right. But he's not Grimes, see? His, appetite is expanding. See, he craves feedback. He needs a larger... audience. I know where he is.
I wanna live!
Authorities still refuse to come.
comment on rumors that a former LAPD officer now serving time for homicide has been released from prison to help with the manhunt.
Oh, they must really be worried they let out Inmate Barnes. He scared you, didn't he? And if you get scared, you might make a mistake, do something foolish.
Come on, man, I know it's you! Meanwhile, L.A. County residents are flocking to gun shops and sporting goods stores throughout the area. And are running.
Where would you go?
The political sensitivity of the immigration issue and the possibility of closing the American borders seems certain to guarantee a television audience of unprecedented size.
To have their markets and their culture overrun by refugees from the third world, to whom even poverty here in paradise would be preferable to the living hell they created in their own worlds.
As you speak, I'm reminded of another group of immigrants, the Puritans. Let us speak with an open mind. If you close off U.S. borders to immigration, you close off your soul to the future and doom this country to cultural extinction. This nation has always...
Hey, what's going on in there? We just lost New York.
Just totally shut down.
What?
Wait a minute.
Are you guys asleep?
Ladies and gentlemen, my fellow Americans.
The hell?
Welcome.
What the hell's happening out there?
No! To Death TV.
So, people, what do you want? Strangulation? Mutilation? Cannibalism? Gunshots? Stabbings? I'll slice, I'll dice, I'll julienne. What about hanging? By the testicles. But before we begin, a word to the parents of our younger viewers.
The following program will contain scenes of violence that will not be suitable for small children.
The rest of you won't be able to take your eyes off the screen.
Don't fucking move.
And now, on with the show.
A Death TV special segment.
You know what floor the studio's on?
38th floor.
Our first little contestant comes to us from our very own City of Angels. At only 9 years of age,
Carrie Carter, a baseball fan and player,
and lover of macaroni and cheese. Daughter of renowned criminal psychologist Madison Carter. Maddie,
you
of course, is one of the friends of the show.
Listen, as God is my witness,
I'm gonna find your daughter, I promise you that, but I need your help.
This little girl.
You gotta find out who's in charge of the building, get him to turn off all the phone lines. He's gonna cut off all the phone lines. Now, can you do that? Can you do that?
Go, go, let's move it! Move it inside, go!
This little beauty's got 2 whole hours until she gets blown into little beauty bits.
Madison,
we'll have some glorious hours.
I'll find your daughter for you.
Help me.
And building excitement, finally coming to the glorious climax.
There's Barnes, there. There.
Where?
There.
Barnes!
Go!
Go!
Mark,
go down the hall, fan out your man!
Go!
Go!
Get out!
While we wait and watch the demise of young Karen Carter, let's have a talk with our studio audience.
You're the supervisor, right?
Yeah.
You can do it.
I don't know if I can, okay?
Now, I need you to cut every phone line that leads into this building.
Imagine, if you can, just for a moment, that she is your daughter. A child you have given birth to. Only now, to be completely and utterly helpless and unable to save.
Oh, my.
Where's my daughter?
I don't know. And what will you do now? Shoot me?
Folks at home? Ed.
Ed?
Folks at home.
Enjoying the show, Ed? At moments like this, I bet you're thinking,
where's God? I have that same dilemma. Oh, look at that response, Ed. I love you.
What I am is not my fault. It's not even my choice. I came to be because of what
you are. They love you so much, they want you dead. Ed.
Face it, folks, to kill
is in your nature.
What the hell happened to the phone lines?
Where's my audience? Where's my audience? Parker!
Come on!
get the little girl, Parker. Come and get the little girl. Oh, come on, you can make it. Come on. Come on, yeah. Attaboy. You can do it. Come on, Parker.
Yeah! Oh.
Okay, Parker. This one's for me.
Mr. Barnes, by destroying Sid, you've effectively lost any chance you had of finding the little girl.
No.
You see? Sid assumes he's still in the real world.
Oh, go on, Maddie. Forget the kid.
Where is she?
You really want to know?
Yes.
You really, really want to know?
Yeah.
Just click your heels 3 times.
Oh, Karen! Mommy's here.
She's here?
Yes, she is.
She's been right here all along.
Uh-huh. Oh.
You're dead.
And you're back in the box.
This is VR.
That's right.
Get us out of here, Billy.
Get him out now.
Madison first. You'll have to help me lift her out.
Daryl! They couldn't have done this without you, Daryl.
Come on, open it.
I'll go lower barn.
Daryl! I'm back in the fucking box!
Smart. That's my boy.
Any time now, Billy.
Daryl! 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 Help me, Daryl. Back in the box, Daryl. Help me, Daryl. Daryl! For my sake! Why did you betray me? Daryl! Judas! Judas, Daryl!
Billy!
No!
So the bomb squad is 5 minutes away.
Yeah, well, we don't have 5 minutes.
Go to the other side
of the room.
Karen!
Listen, I'm gonna get you out of here, okay?
Where you are.
It's all right, sweetheart. We're gonna get you out of here.
You're gonna get me out of here?
Yes, I'm gonna get you out.
Be careful, Parker.
Mom, hurry.
Okay, wait. Don't move.
Hello, Parker. That can only be you. What should now be completely clear is that anything you can think of, I've already thought of. And I thought of it first. So I made this little recording just for you, in case you got clever.
All right, let me move your hands back. Just stay right where you are. Don't move. Oh. He's got you sitting on a pressure plate. Now, if you stand up, it's gonna be very bad, okay?
Be still, honey. Don't move. It's okay, baby. So, hang in there. Don't move, honey.
Mom, get me out of here.
We will, baby. Just hang on. Everything will be okay, Karen. Just stay still.
Mom. Mommy.
Hold on, baby.
To Mommy.
Mama.
I'm right here, sweetie. Try to get into the main operating system and reset the internal clock.
I thought of that one, too. Better try again.
No. Oh, God.
Oh. Faster.
Hang on, baby. Everything's gonna be okay. I love you here.
Thank you. Looking at the street lights, all spread out like a banquet. Why is this room so silent? Only when I'm moving, no direction chosen. Rolling over emotion, guess I'm your party man. I'm a party man, I'm a party man, I'm your party man. I'm a party man, I'm a party man, I'm your party man. So then, up upon this sidewalk, looking at the street lights, all spread out like a banquet. Why is this room so silent? Only when I'm moving, no direction chosen. Rolling over emotion, guess I'm your party man.